as we are better at understanding both the biology of cancer, the various targets or genetic abnormalities, for instance, that are causing a particular cancer, we can be smarter, and we can look at what we have available to target those, the biology or those abnormalities. And in many cases, they're available to us or were available to us. We just didn't know how to use them before. As an example, so cancer cells require an extensive amount of nutrition. You might think of them as a very revved up cell, and so their metabolism level, so to speak, is fairly high. And what we found is that there are some agents that are used in other venues that will affect metabolism overall. One example is the drug hydroxychloroquine. It's used for malaria prevention. It's actually used in some rheumatologic conditions. And as it turns out, it affects one pathway in a cell's metabolism. And because cancer cells require more metabolism, higher levels of fuel, it hurts cancer cells in the laboratory more than it hurts normal cells. Other examples include the drug metformin, and there's evidence in many larger studies that metformin might have a kind of a preventive effect. If a drug is already approved for one indication, and we can have prove it that it has effectiveness in another use, it is usually a much shorter timeline to approval. When we have a center such as here in New Jersey, is an NCI designated, National Cancer Institute designated center, we have the opportunity to launch many of these efforts in clinical trials, which really brings state of the art opportunities in clinical trials to patients way before they may get approved. There's no doubt that we've made great strides as a research community nationally and globally. If you look back, 30 or so years ago, patients coming in any of these doors or any doors with cancer, only about 50% of them survived beyond 5 years, or what we would consider in many cases cure. Nowadays, it's close to 70%. So we really have done a lot. Some of it's because of preventive screening strategies. Some of it's because of more effective therapies, better access to therapies, and much of it is because of the new targeted agents that are much more effective.